Hi everyone, in this video we will learn how to install Apache Superset on Ubuntu. I am working with the Jammy Jellyfish version of Ubuntu. Apache Superset is an open source data exploration and visualization tool that connects to SQL-based databases, allowing users to create interactive dashboards and data visualizations without needing a dedicated storage layer. Superset provides two primary interfaces: the Explore view for no-code visualization building, and SQL Lab, a SQL IDE for advanced data manipulation. Designed to handle large datasets, Superset relies on the performance of the connected database engine, making it suitable for both small and enterprise-scale use cases. Its configuration options support customizations in authentication, security, and resource management. Let us get into the installation. In my terminal, I am going to run sudo apt update to update the package information within the apt package manager. The most common way to install and access Superset is with Python. Please note, as of the recording of this video, November 2024, Apache Superset does not work with Python 3.12 or later. You will need to run Python 3.11 or earlier to work with Apache Superset. First, I will install packages we will need to run Superset. The Build Essential package includes compilers and tools for building C and C++ extensions, which may be utilized in some Python packages. libssldev is used to connect databases over HTTPS, which we will need for Superset. libffidev, also known as the Foreign Function Interface Library, is used for certain dependencies that require interaction with C extensions. Python 3dev contains the development headers and libraries needed to compile Python modules with C or C++ extensions. Python 3pip is used as the Python package manager, and Python 3venv allows us to create Python virtual environments to better manage Python packages. I will create a Python virtual environment where I will install Apache Superset. To create a virtual environment, I will run the following command. I need to activate the virtual environment using the source command. Once you successfully enter the virtual environment, you will see the name of the environment in the terminal. Now I can install Superset using the pip package manager. Now that Superset is installed, I will create an environment variable named flaskapp. Superset uses the Flask module as its web framework. From here, I will set up a secure configuration for Apache Superset by setting up a secret key. For example, the secret key will sign session cookies to ensure the data has not been altered. First, I will generate a secure random key with OpenSSL. I am going to copy the key, then I will create a Python script that stores the secret key. Please note, you should store this script in a secure location, such as within the etc directory. In my case, I am keeping it in the home directory just for ease of use for this tutorial, but you should not keep the Python script in the home directory in a development or production environment. Using the nano editor, I will create the Python script and name it superset_config.py. Within the script, I will create a string variable called secret key, and this will store the secret key I created earlier. I will set another environment variable named superset config path. This environment variable tells the Apache Superset program where the configuration script is that we just created. Running the following command will set up and maintain an internal database schema for Apache Superset. Now I will create an admin user to maintain, run, and configure Superset using the following command. I need to set the username, input the first and last name of the user's email, and the user's password to log in to the Superset application. I am going to load in example datasets from Superset. This will take a few minutes to run. To initialize Superset, I will call superset init. Finally, I will start the Superset web server. I'm going to set the port to 8088. The with threads flag enables multi-threading to allow multiple requests concurrently. The reload flag enables auto-reloading of the server whenever changes are detected in the source code. The debugger flag enables the interactive debugger, which provides error messages in the browser if an error occurs. We can see that our server is starting and it is running. I am going to go to the browser to take a look at Superset. To bring up Superset in the browser, I am going to search for a localhost at port 8088. I need to log in with the username and password I set earlier. And we are in. I am going to take a look at the Slack dashboard, which is an artificial data set which simulates data related to interactions in a simulated workspace. It may take Superset a few seconds to load in the dashboard. We can see that we have various charts laid out, from the number of weekly messages to time zones for members to messages per channel. Thanks everyone for watching. I hope that this video was helpful. In the description, I included the link for the Apache Superset documentation. If you found the video helpful, feel free to like and subscribe. You can also connect with me on LinkedIn, X, GitHub, Medium, and Odyssey. I also have a podcast called The Aspiring STEM Geek, which you can check out on YouTube, Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Audible, and iHeartRadio. Thanks again for watching and happy coding.